It's Sybil Wilkes with What You Need to Know. Today is Thursday, August 20th, 2020. Number one, history met history last night at the Democratic National Convention. Barack Obama, the first black president of the United States, spoke on behalf of his vice president, Joe Biden, and told folks democracy is at stake. Senator Kamala Harris, the first black woman on a major party ticket, accepted her nomination. In addition to Senator Harris were speeches by Senator Elizabeth Warren and 2016 presidential nominee Hillary Clinton. Did I hear some "I tried to tell you" in there? Number two, leaders with the Charlotte Hornets NBA team have suspended their radio broadcaster after tweeting the N-word during a game on Monday between the Utah Jazz and Denver Nuggets. John Fock apologized for the horrific error after he claims he mistyped the N-word but meant it to spell Nuggets. Fock has been suspended indefinitely until a full investigation is completed. Number three, health officials are voicing concern about the federal government's lack of tracking COVID-19 outbreaks in K-12 schools just as the fall semester has begun nationwide. Some states are not publicly reporting them and are instead relying on local officials to decide which information to make public and which information to share only with affected students and parents. Critics believe a lack of accounting will be detrimental to efforts to identify effective safety measures to put into place to slow the spread of the virus. Number four, happy National Radio Day, and what better day to pay tribute to legendary broadcaster Donnie Simpson. Congratulations to our own love bug Donnie, who was named to the 2020 class of the Radio Hall of Fame this week. Check out the tribute written by fan and colleague Chris Paul in today's newsletter. Number five, Akon City, a futuristic cryptocurrency-themed city founded by music mogul Akon, is ready to begin construction in Senegal after securing $4 billion from investors. The city will exclusively use the Acoin digital currency and plans to have parks, universities, schools, a stadium, hotels, and more. It will be the de facto currency in a city he's constructing on land donated by the government. Join me today live on YouTube and Facebook at 7 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Central. George Wallace will be with me as we discuss today's headlines and more. That's what you need to know. For more information, please go to SybilWilkes.com. Sign up for my free newsletter. Be informed, be empowered.